What makes Fender different in the marketplace today is there's a distinct sound. You know, there's a Fender sound that's been there since the late 40s, early 50s. It'll always be there. And you listen to a record, you know a Fender. You hear a Strat, you hear a Tele, and you can tell the difference between any other instrument. There's a magic to it, there's a tone to it, there's a soul to it that is very distinctive, just hearing it.
Fender amplifier sound lets all the emotion and sound of the guitar come through. And these amplifiers, where you put your fingers on the guitar, how hard you play it, these all make a difference in the sound. And it's something where all of the artist's subtle nuances come through.
The ultimate sounds known in the 20th century have been on one of these. I mean, you can play. You know, you can play like that. Or you can just use it for rock and roll, which is like.
The variety of sounds you can get with the Fender, you know? That's why you see a lot of other guitar companies go under, because they'll market specifically for one market, while Fender quality is so dynamic that it can be used in country, it can be used in heavy metal, it can be used in just straight rock and roll. And a lot of other sounds. It's a very versatile guitar, and that's important in the Fender quality.
First time that I heard a Fender that I wanted to play, when I realized that tone, I said, what is that tone? That doesn't sound like any of the guitars I'm hearing around here, was when I first heard Layla, Derek and the Dominoes album, and Clapton's guitar sound. And it just sounded tremendous to me. It had clarity, but it had body, and it really changed my idea about what a guitar sounded like.
No one has ever really recreated the sound, you know, and just, it's just a Fender. I like it. I like the way it feels on me. I like it the way it feels around me. I like the way I feel when I play it, knowing that it's a Fender, and knowing that there's such a heritage there, and such a legacy of great, great musicians that's played these guitars down through the years.
Nashville was Telecaster heaven, you know. And every record that came out of Nashville in the 60s seemed to have that chicken picking and the old Johnny Cash songs, you know, like I Walk the Line. It wouldn't have been the same without a Fender guitar.
It became everybody's guitar. I believe everybody one time or another had to have a Fender to play. God said, let there be Fender, and there was.
Working on the guitars, you just think every one goes someplace different. One will end up in somebody's closet, another might get smashed on stage, another might become a priceless antique someday, depending on who ends up picking it out of the box and playing it.
What I do at Fender is I shape the neck, fine sand them, getting ready for spray, and so usually all the custom work always sign my name in the back. So you know, it just shows that a little pride on what you do.
very people-oriented, very product-oriented company. We are very concerned that the customer gets the product that he wants, that he expects as far as the quality goes.
What I do here at Fender is I'm a tuner tester. I do technical inspection and I do some setup on the guitar, mostly to create a good feel for the instrument before it gets to the customers.
It's a great job, and it's really neat to see your work on television, on MTV, or you see a rock star you really like playing a guitar that you could have worked on. It makes you feel really good.
You look at the artists that are the artists, the ones that really are the top talents, and the ones that have polished their art to just such a fine degree are Fender artists. And it's wonderful, it's thrilling. And to know that it seems as though the best vehicle for transferring emotion is a Fender.
Fenders seem to allow the personality of the player to come through better than other guitars do. Other guitars tend to make homogenize people. They all start sounding the same through with other guitars, I find. And with you can instantly recognize with Fenders, A, which model of guitar it is, and B, who's playing it.
My first love was the Fender Strat and the Fender Bassman. I was playing the Strat, trying to do as much like Guitar Slim as I could, because I copied a lot off of him. And Eric tells me in a later date that him and Beck caught me that night and changed the whole world of playing Strats, and they just all went for the Strat and the sound that I was getting, and I'm thankful they did that because they have helped me a lot since then.
It's up to us to do something with what has been given to us, Every so often, man comes up with a correct invention. The wheel was a good idea, wasn't it? To have that round was a very good idea. And this thing that I'm holding just seems to cover all the complete spectrum of human emotion, right from down there to up there. And in between, you've got everything you can shake a stick at.
It's basically anything you want it to be. It's going to translate your feelings, your emotions, the thing that you're going to turn into music or song. You're gonna send that through it, and a Fender has always been almost the best thing to do it with.
I was more influenced by people like in the metal field back then. I don't know if you know the band Iron Maiden. Steve Harris, the bass player in that group. I saw Steve Harris, and it was like this guy was a great bass player, and he was a great showman, and I wanted to do something like that, and he always played Fenders. And that, sticks in your head like that. And I had a Fender already, so I was like, Steve, that's cool,
As styles change and tastes change, you have to incorporate those changes into the product that's on the market. Artist relations has always been a very important part of product development. And since I've been at Fender, I've heard stories of the early years with Leo inviting the early country stars over to his shop. The things they had to tell him were directly responsible for him coming up with his original product.
Which made Fender a standard from that point on, because he researched it from the artist's point of view rather than a manufacturing point of view.
And it was great being at the front end of Fender's existence back in the early days and watching what it became.
So we're taking the best of the old sounds and some new features and doing things that are as valid today as those 59 Bassmans and 65 Twin Reverbs were. We're going around and we're talking to a lot of artists and players and just finding out, hey, what would you really like?
Fender Musical Instruments and I came up with the idea of this guitar. They worked very closely with me in getting what I needed from a Rogue guitar, my favorites being the Tele and the Strat, to get the best of both in one. So for me, it's the ultimate Fender that I can take out on the road.
That basically is my position at the company, is to build for the artists. The foundation of what we do is a passion. Everybody that you talk to that reaches that position, I guess, in the company, goes beyond the income. It goes beyond anything that we do. It becomes what we do.
In approximately 46, when Leo founded the company, he was making what we call lap steel guitars, and then developed through his little electric shop that he had at the time, the Fender amplifier.
And the original Fender amps were really musical instruments. If it had not been for Fender amps in the first place, the sound of music wouldn't be what it is today. When you listen to a record or a CD and you hear a guitar, whether it's a Fender amp or not, it's really based on an original Fender design.
The function of this operation and the way it works is pretty much like an entrepreneurial environment where the small company, we have a small staff, and everybody works together, and there's a constant interaction from the people on the staff, whether it be engineers, myself, and the people on the production floor.
The products that we're doing for Pro Sound are unique and they're really interesting. They range anywhere from small, low-cost powered mixers for bands that are just starting out, kids playing in their garage, to a heavy metal group, to the largest concert sound system. We have a line of very, very high-end concert sound equipment now that outperforms some of the most expensive touring sound standards on the market.
At Sun, we started out with tube amps and went into solid state, and now we are coming back with tube amps and solid state. It's a mixed variety now. But I really think Fender does have a good unit, and I'm not a rock and roll fan either. All right.
We have a lot of new machinery, computerized. Tolerance are closer. Everybody say, well, geez, it's just, you know, sanding wood or making holes, whatever. But it's not as easy as that. So the product is a lot better than years ago.
We probably now have 200 to 300 models in our line of products. We're making guitars from entry-level customer up to the top artist. We're making amplifiers for the entry-level customer up to the top artist. And PA for the traveling bands and studios, and also for installation in ballparks or wherever.
We have never had any worries about Fender. Fender seems to be like the flagship of companies. We wish all of the companies could be like Fender. They have the customer or the guitar player ultimately in mind. And when you get into a problem, it's not a question of, well, how we're going to do this. It's just get the problem fixed, get the guy back on the road.
All my friends play Fenders, you know?
Everybody plays a Fender, man. Where you been? Everybody, all my friends play Fenders.
I would just like to be known as, you know, one of those guys that, you know, that played a Fender.
Everything that was ever great about Fender amps in the first place is still relevant today. All we need to do is keep up with all the subtle changes that go on with popular trends and playing styles.
And when I touched it, I said, I can handle this. I can handle the sound, I can handle the feeling.
And I think these Strats, Defender guitars, is just that way. If you get hooked on it, there's just no way you'll get unhooked, man. You know, it's just, I haven't, and I've been at it for quite a while.
It has been invented. The ultimate has been invented, and this is it.
Fender is a a legendary name with a great heritage, and the management's position is that we must expand upon that heritage, and we must keep that legendary name alive.
As much as you rest on the laurels, you know, I mean, how do you do better than a Strat? How do you better than a Tele or a P-Bass or a Jazz Bass? We've got to, you know. We've got to keep pushing the envelope, keep pushing it, keep pushing it.
Fender as a company doesn't stop with what was done in 1954 or 1964 or any other time period. What we are as a company and what we're doing is being formed right now, and we get the chance to really help form the instruments that's going to shape the face of music for the next 20 and 30 years.